Another edition of Sam Choi's In the Kitchen. I'm Stu Chef John Venere, and of course, this is world-renowned chef Sam Choi, and we are at the house of former jiu-jitsu champion, former racquetball champion, all-around good guy and a good friend of ours, Egan Inouye.
Great guy.
Good shape. Can't wait to see what's in the fridge.
Let's go.
Hey. Egan, Marcia, hello.
Thank you.
How are you, sir?
Come on in.
Look, you're such great shape.
Oh, but you guys look like you got 150% fit. Thank
you. We're trying. We're working on it.
Thanks for having us.
Cold, man. You got a cold glass out of this fridge. I love it. Oh, man. Chicken, Johnny. Oh, man. Organic.
Yeah.
So no fat. There's like no fat on this at all. Mushrooms, man. Oh, shiitake. Oh, man. Portabella.
Who cooks?
She cooks.
So what would you normally do with this?
Just bake it, probably. Yeah.
Oh, man. Johnny, some scallop.
Scallops.
Is bread?
The multi.
A crust of bread. Bacon. Oh, your favorite.
Atkins diet.
You guys actually eat bacon?
Oh, yeah.
Broccoli. I love broccoli. Right now, at our house on Kona, somebody brought us like avocados like this with small seeds like this, just sitting there. I put up a sign. I said, "Help yourself." They're amazing. Nice cherry tomatoes. Oh, Maui herbs. Oh, nice. Well, you guys eat very healthy.
We try to.
Well, I mean, look at them. Wow, man, that's a real nice assortment of really healthy, fresh, and good food.
All right. It's time for the mystery box, Box Choi. This is a challenge by our friends at Kraft & Heinz. We have to use the ingredients as part of our assortment of food. So I'll let you do the honors, and then you can hand it to Egan after.
Okay. Oh, your favorite. Right,
so my favorite.
Heinz vinegar, yeah.
No, I smell vinegar.
That's okay.
Oh, I like that.
And then gray poupon, Dijon poupon, mustard. And then we got
grapefruit.
It's Jabon. Which is actually in the Michael Jackson song.
Jabon! Jabon! What? We're going to make a nice dressing with this. You guys have honey?
A dressing?
Yeah.
With the Jabon?
Yeah.
We're going to make a dressing.
Yes.
Awesome.
So,
keep it healthy, right?
Well, I mean, come on, John.
Between boot camp, cryotherapy, writing books,
raising a family,
defending women,
I'm gonna make a nice salad. I got some really nice stuff. I'm gonna cut some nice florets out of beautiful broccoli. Did you handpick this or?
Oh, yeah. Handpick from the grocery store.
So people kind of like, pick their broccoli like this. And the first thing they do, they chop it right here. No, you want to kind of like maybe just take that part off just a little bit. And then you want to just kind of like do this. Just peel that off. But you just want to do that right there. See that? You know, and then if you want to, you don't want to tear it, you just cut that part off right there like that. Okay? So you want to go at an angle like that. Keep that there. So you split that.
You don't waste much.
So like asparagus, right? You get long pieces of asparagus. These are the real good part of the broccoli, you know, besides the florets. See, well, I just spit that there, but that's okay. Look how beautiful the florets, see? Again, do the same thing. You want to cut just a little bit off of that, and then like that, okay? So I'm going to have you guys do that.
Yeah.
Oh, you up for that?
I'm assuming he doesn't do it.
His specialty is omelets with lots of cheese.
You know what? Omelets are good. Breakfast is good. Breakfast for dinner is good.
I like this knife.
You know what?
It's nice and sharp.
You let me use that knife early on.
Oh, you have to graduate to this knife?
Yeah, well, I do.
Oh, so I feel privileged.
Yeah, well, you know, I have to do that to John because, you know, he's really...
I'm really what?
You're good.
Oh, okay.
You know, John, without you, man, this thing's gonna pop. How you doing, okay?
Yeah, very I don't know. Good. How does it look?
Very
okay?
Good.
Okay?
Yeah.
Okay, Uncle Sam, what are we doing with that now?
Okay, we're gonna blanch that, and the secret to blanching is you want to get the greenness of the vegetables really popping, you know, get a really bright green. Because this is natural green. This is like how you pick it off of the garden. The garden.
The garden.
So you add a little salt in your water.
Okay.
You drop it in, maybe 1 or 2 minutes. If you drop it all in, then the water just stops boiling.
Okay.
When the water starts to move again, that's done. Then you want to shock it in cold water.
That's a good tip.
Yeah, it's a very good tip.
That is my cue.
Okay, and then we're gonna pick some lettuce. I want you guys to pick, just kind of like dust your board a little bit. So, you bought some nice organic hydroponic lettuces.
Lettuces.
Lettuce, butter leaf lettuce.
So that is a new word, lettuces.
Get your broccoli going. This guy. So what I wanna do is have you guys just pluck it just like that. Leave it whole, and we're gonna put it right in here. And it saved the heart, about that much of the heart, okay? Dainty hands now.
Oh, dainty hands.
Open.
Maybe I shouldn't.
Soft but quick. We got the tomatoes and the. Oh, I'm gonna have you pick some of the basil.
Can you reach over? It's mint,
I think. Oh, mint?
You want mint?
Oh, mint. So, like, who writes the menu at home? You guys just cook.
I eat to live. I eat to survive. I don't survive to eat, so.
Yeah, that's a good
one. I don't have a choice.
Can we say that again, please?
Don't believe him.
Wait, what was that?
I eat to live, not live to eat.
Oh, shucks.
Okay, that's good. I want to save that part right there. We're going to have you rinse it, and we're going to drain that dry. Pluck all the mint leaves there, just a little bit. We still have a lot of big mint patches at home, and our dogs, we have Basenjis. They would go in the mint patches, and when they come back in, they smell like mint. Right? Okay, so the only problem when you sit down and cook, you kind of just take your time, because it's so comfortable, you know, when you're sitting down and cook.
It's relaxing.
Yeah, it is. I just put it right on top of that. They're going to have you rinse it in some cold water. If you got another colander, we just drain that dry. Egan, you and I are going to make our scallops.
What are you going to do with the scallops?
I'm going to just make some... kind of like...
I see the bacon. The bacon's close.
We're going to bacon wrap it.
Yes.
Oh, these are nice scallops, man.
Hey, you're right about it turning green, real green.
Nice, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, so what I'm going to do, take our bacon. So I like to kind of like at an angle, stretch your bacon out. This is a nice cut bacon. And add a bias cut, just... cut it just like this, and then you can actually season it, but because the bacon is salt, you don't want to season it too much. Okay, then you're just gonna wrap it just like that. Pull it tight, just like that.
Wow.
Look how nice.
Looks good.
And you take your skewer like this. This is what I want to do. So you kind of like just put it at an angle. And then you just skewer it just like this. Twist it. Don't push. Just twist it back and forth. Almost like a ramaki. Yeah. And then what you can do, you can just cut this right like this. And you put one right on top of that. And you bake it in the oven like that. Put our trash in a mulch. This is fun, eh, Egan?
Look how pretty. Yeah. And so, okay, so what are you guys doing now?
We're taking our scallop.
Okay.
Okay. And we're gonna just roll with bacon, just like that. Put it down on your surface of your board. Okay. And you take your skewer.
Your skewer.
It kind of like really comes really nice like that. See?
Perfect.
And a nice little tomato. And you can leave that on there just like that.
But you see how nice the broccoli is, right?
Beautiful.
And so,
very
okay,
good.
So what? And then what will you do with the scallops? Because how will you cook that?
Then we're gonna bake it in the oven, John.
You're gonna bake it in the oven.
Uh-huh. We got the bacon wrap there. Okay, look at this.
Oh, wow,
I've done bacon wrap asparagus, but never bacon wrap broccoli.
Oh yeah, it's really good. You know, just get a little different things, right?
Bacon makes everything taste.
Right.
Bacon does. Okay, so there we go.
Whether you call this jabong or buluk or pamplemousse, the pomelo is one of Hawaii's favorite backyard fruits. Often mistaken for grapefruit, the pomelo is actually the parent of a grapefruit, which was originally created by grafting a pomelo with an orange. And this tree will bear more than fruit. The bark and sap can be cooked down to make a cough syrup, and the leaves can be applied to calm skin rashes. But what do you do with dozens of fruit when it's in season?
We made lavash, we made a bread, and we made a salad. Jabong is so versatile, and what I did is because we had so much of it, I pureed it and made juice to freeze, and so we'll always have a stash.
So I think we've given Sam some pretty good ideas. What do you say? Back to you in the kitchen.
Thanks, Pam. Here we have a nice island jabong.
Jabong?
Or like what we call it, grapefruit, Asian grapefruit.
Okay.
Or, I don't think that's right. We call it jabong all the time we grew up. But I'm gonna make a dressing with this.
Really?
With our two items that
our
came
Heinz
on.
Distilled white vinegar and our Grey Poupon Dijon mustard.
So I like to just kind of like peel it like how you peel a pineapple. And then you want to kind of like just turn that over like that and just cut this part off just like that. You guys want to try this?
It smells good too.
Want to try it?
Yeah.
Try it.
Try it.
Is it good? Yeah?
So that's what I like to do, just desec them like this, take the segments out.
Desec them?
The segments. Okay, so you think you got a lot of juice out of here now. Watch this. So you just kind of do this. Look at this. And that is like pure jabong juice. You know, one time we were like at an all-you-can-eat buffet, and, you know, I was popping the cherry tomatoes in my mouth like as if, you know, eating popcorn. And then after a while, you just don't want to chew, so you go like this. Man, I bit on one, and all the seeds flew out, hit the lady in the back of her. Yes, I looked at it, and you know, she didn't feel it. And you can see all the seeds just sliding.
Oh, no. Oh,
I was young, man. I was really nervous. Man. Oh, my God. Okay, so you got that really nice. Look how much juice we got. This will make a nice vinaigrette. Then I'm going to take out the seeds here. You know, you can plant this. You want to plant a tree? And you might be a senior in high school when you get your first jabong.
Yeah.
Look at the seeds.
Wow.
I'm gonna just chop this up really fine, real quick. John, how's our fire, our oven?
It's preheating.
Pass me the vinegar and the Dijon.
Oh. Yeah, that loose for me.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
He's got that grip.
And you know, when I watch you exercise, you know, you do some TV spots.
Yeah.
I don't wanna see you make it look effortless, but man.
But he makes it look effortless.
But it's intense, though.
About how much on that? Oh.
One,
two, three and a half
teaspoon. Oh, this is gonna be really nice. Look at this. So all we're gonna add to this now is honey and olive oil. That's it. And a little black pepper.
About how much of the Heinz vinegar did you put in there?
Two teaspoons. Yeah.
Two tablespoons of honey. That'll sweeten it up a little bit. And about one teaspoon, two teaspoons, three teaspoons, four teaspoons, five teaspoons.
Okay, well now I'm gonna decorate and kind of like make it a nice little presentation here. So that's what we're gonna do, because we can. The cucumber. Remember when you were young, your parents made you do this to take out the bitterness from the cucumber? You guys ever did that?
No.
Well, they said you did that. You see all that white stuff that comes out?
Mm-hmm.
They said that's the bitterness of the cucumber.
I've never seen that.
You see that right there, all that white stuff? Yeah, the milk. How you guys eat you guys cucumbers at home?
Just sliced up.
Just like this?
Yeah, Jet. Just like that raw, right?
You like that, Jet? So beautiful lettuce leaves. This is fun, man. I just love doing stuff like this. You know, we're just building a salad, okay? Taking something really simple, because what's gonna happen is we're gonna sear some salmon.
Ooh, thank you. Perfect. Yoshida's original. And what are you gonna do with this? With the salmon?
Yeah, what I wanna do is I'm gonna cut the salmon. We're gonna sear it. So I want you to season it with some salt, pepper, not too much. Skin side down.
Skin side down.
And let it sit on that side until it kind of goes almost halfway.
Okay.
And just turn it over for 1 or 2 minutes, it's done.
Turn it over.
Finish it with a little Yoshida.
Okay.
And then I want to fold just a little bit of that with butter in it at the end. Put a nice platter and then put some shiitake mushroom and we're done.
Okay, Uncle Sam, recap what we did here.
First of all, we had a nice, beautiful salad with the nice broccoli, and then of course some nice butter leaf lettuce, some fresh cucumbers, some nice tomatoes, and a nice local avocado.
Then you used our bok choy.
We did our bok choy ingredient.
The Heinz vinegar. Did you put the Dijon mustard in?
Yes, the Dijon mustard was in there, and then add a little honey.
And the Jabong juice.
The Jabong juice and some tomatoes in there. And then of course we did the bacon wrapped scallops. Yeah, a little different. And we have some broccoli that we wrapped with bacon.
And then the last thing we did
and
was?
And then we took some of that nice fresh salmon you folks got, sauteed it up, and then we finished it with some Yoshidas, some sweet chili and butter. And then we took the nice shiitake mushroom, sauteed that up with a little olive oil and a little bit of butter, and finished it with that Aloha Shoyu Asian Gold. Yeah, hey, come on, guys. I tell you what, John is really becoming a chef.
Thank
the salmon
you.
Is really good, John.
You know what? That is a huge compliment.
And that's not a scolding. Thank you, John.
Thank you. You're going to have to serve the girls because I want to talk a little bit. I want everyone to get to know Egan and Marcia a little bit better. First thing I noticed was the shirt, and then I realized what it is. And it's because of this guy right here. But Becoming Relentless is a book, obviously, by you, relentlessly trying to achieve your dreams. I mean, it can mean a whole lot of things.
Yeah,
and it does,
basically,
right?
that's what it really means, just being relentless and never giving up. You know, in that book, it basically just goes through different things that I went through in my life and, you know, how I got around it and all the struggles. You know, hopefully, it's put out to inspire people, you know, to let people know that they can do anything that they want. So a lot of people think that, like, you know, I was lucky or I was, you know, I'm good at everything I do, and it's totally not true. You know, it's like I'm junk at a lot of things. Right? You guys saw me cook.
I did see you try to whisk that. I did see the whisk.
That was right.
Well, I would think that you are relentless in all the things that you have achieved, but together you guys have achieved something else, a business, Cryotherapy Hawaii, which by the way is great for relieving pain and inflammation, and it's something that I hope to continue to do with you.
Basically, we brought it to Hawaii for me because I'm getting old and I want to keep training. And then we found out that we couldn't have it in the house, so we had to get a gas, the nitrogen, uh-huh. You know, and we had to be at a commercial spot, so
okay.
We opened up Cryotherapy Hawaii.
So it gets really cold, but it's not a painful cold. We were talking about that,
yeah.
Because I've stuck my foot in ice cold water,
yeah.
And that's painful, but this is not painful.
This is not, if you've done that, then this is not painful at all.
And so, women use it for anti-aging and health benefits. So, yeah, it's supposed to help shrink your pores. So we have the cryofacial, which is great.
Nice. Well, I know that a lot of people are raving about it. You can sign up at cryotherapyhawaii.com or you can come down
and make an appointment. And if you enter your email, you get 50% off your first treatment. So, yeah, we'd love to have more people visit us.
Now, I know a lot of people know you guys for boot camp. You said you have how many people doing boot camp?
We have over 900 members.
900. Congratulations.
More than 900.
I know for years you've done this too, but you with daughters, me with daughters, I love the fact that you teach women self-defense.
Yeah, so much of our company is about empowering women, like in through fitness and through the self-defense.
And the self-defense is non-striking. I always believe that. Right? So my thing is about getting away, breaking holds. When a lady's in the most trouble, they're on the ground. That's how we came about with
that's awesome. Self-defense. I want to just say thank you so much for having us and the crew and all the folks that are watching in your house, in your kitchen, and eating your food. It's been great. And I was shocked to see bacon. Yeah, I don't know why I was shocked to see bacon, because you guys are so fit, and I think bacon is a fatty thing, but I guess it's not.
No carbs.
which I love the fact that there's no carbs here, yes. So thank you so much for having us, and thank you for cooking all their food.
No, yes, thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, it's an honor to have you guys.
It's exactly how John feels. I feel the same way. Thank you guys so much.
But remember,
when Sam Choi is in the kitchen,
you can do the cooking. Oh, I see. They're working together here. He's wrapping, and she's skewering.
You know what they call this in a movie industry, yeah, John?
What is that?
It's a wrap.
Oh. Stale joke number one.
Fantastic.
Twirly, twirly. Don't forget the twirly, twirly.
Oh, good, John. Took you 10 times to learn it. He just did it one time.
Wait a minute.
Oh, yeah, sorry.
It looks pretty.